Welcome back. The coronavirus has greatly impacted every aspect of daily life and created some new challenges for communities, industries, and countries around the world. Through IBM Call for Code, it's a $30 million five-year global challenge. IBM is working with the global developer community to find new solutions to help fight the pandemic now and in the future. My guest is Daniel Krook, the Chief Technology Officer of IBM Code and Response and Call for Code. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me, Audrey.
Tell us more about Call for Code.
Sure. As you mentioned, it's a multi-year initiative. Every year it has a different competition, though, that addresses one of the world's most pressing challenges. So the last 2 years, we focused on natural disaster solutions. And this year, we're also taking on some large pressing issues that, you know, that affect us all in many ways. So we've had 300,000 developers so far in the past years and this year come together from 168 nations to really apply new technology to these world's largest issues.
And I think it's amazing that you can work with people across the globe to come up with solutions. So you originally focused on natural disasters, and now you've included another component for the competition this year. Tell us about that.
That's right. So we launched this year's competition in February with a focus on climate change. So looking at ways you can create solutions for energy sustainability, water sustainability, and disaster resiliency. But with the growing threat of the pandemic and the disruption on society, we added a second parallel track for solutions for COVID-19. So how do you create technology solutions for the social and business impacts of the pandemic on people? And we wanted to highlight those applications early, but also we keep the competition open through the end of July for submissions to either track, climate change or COVID-19.
Wonderful. Tell us about some of the developers that have registered.
So this year, we've seen some really great applications come in from around the world. And three that we're highlighting immediately include one from a developer in Los Angeles who created a two-part mobile application for retail stores and customers to safely manage who enters the store at what time digitally. So when the store is ready to admit somebody, that person could be waiting in their car. They could be brought into the store, told when to come in. So it improves social distancing. We've seen solutions from a team in Canada with members from around the world, Bangladesh, Kazakhstan, Mexico. They created a solution for the local Vancouver business community for small businesses to understand what sort of resources are available to them to help them power through the disruption to their business. And we've also seen a third application that we're highlighting from a team in India around helping patients understand whether their symptoms are severe enough that they should actually venture out and go see a medical professional. And conversely, whether those doctors should prioritize somebody for medical care. If they're afraid to come in, we've seen a lot of concerns about people ignoring health issues because they're afraid to venture out when they really should be venturing out. So lots of amazing solutions around the world that we would love to get folks using immediately.
Well, are you also getting people from, say, everyday walks of life with various industries who are also contributing to these solutions?
Yeah, we're seeing developers and experts from lots of different backgrounds come together to create solutions. And in fact, last year's Call for Code winner was a team from Barcelona that was comprised of a developer, a web developer, a data scientist who's looking at analytics, a project manager, a PhD, as well as a firefighter and a nurse, all on the team of five. And so they all had diverse backgrounds, but because they had their end user in mind as they were creating that technology solution, it was much more powerful than if it just came from somebody with a software engineering degree. So we do see that again this year in the solution. So there's folks who are entrepreneurs, who are developers, mobile application developers, people bringing their personal experience and creating solutions to improve the world.
And what I think is really interesting about Call for Code is that, as you just mentioned, that there were first responders and nurses, for instance, who also contributed to one team's effort. So that means it's really important to bring in other voices to come up with a creative solution.
Exactly. Yeah. Team diversity, understanding the real problem, that you're actually not just throwing technology at a perceived problem, that's incredibly important. And what we try to do with Call for Code is to bridge the experts with developers by providing starting points. We call them starter kits. And actually, the developer who created SafeCube built that one using, was brand new to IBM technology, knew how to develop a mobile app, but brought everything together. And we see a lot of new developers too, people that may have not as deep technical backgrounds. Maybe they do only know HTML and how to create a basic website, but using the tools to assemble them together with open source technology and really creating something effective that's going to make a difference, no matter how simple it seems.
It's all about collaboration.
That's right. So Call for Code brings together the United Nations, it brings together the Linux Foundation, and lots of other organizations, public and private, to help mentor the folks who are creating solutions, do tech talks on what are the really pressing issues that do need technology solutions, or ones that have existing solutions that could be integrated with, so people aren't reinventing the wheel. So it's a large initiative, a lot of partners.
Well, you mentioned some of the solutions. Are there other solutions that have been submitted this year that you'd like to tell us about?
There's a lot of amazing things coming in that are focused on our three focus areas under COVID-19. So crisis communications, remote education, community cooperation. We've seen applications come and address issues around those areas as well. So how do you do continuity in teaching? For example, I have an 8-year-old son downstairs who's doing remote learning, but it's not as effective as the classroom experience. So is there a way technology can come to bear to make that a better experience for him and help him continue learning? In these new times.
So you're keeping the competition open through July and you're looking for additional ideas. So how do people submit those ideas?
Yeah, as in previous years, we've ended after a multi-month competition. So people have the time to create really, really great ideas, flesh them out. So they would go to callforcode.org, learn about the schedule, the rules, the judging, and what sort of resources are available to learn from, such as the starter kits that I mentioned. And you can learn there how to take part, how to find team members. And even if you're not just, if you just want to support or sponsor the competition, take part and learn about the solutions, you would go to callforcode.org as well.
Daniel, how do you see these solutions making an impact to the future?
Well, what sets Call for Code apart is that we take the technology, we provide them the support to deploy. And so we really do see that these three, especially for the COVID-19 track, if we can deploy them very quickly, they can make an impact and they can scale around the world as open source solutions. But what's also great about the three I highlighted is that they can be used beyond this current pandemic and used in other contexts. So it's very important that we help them get the support they need now and also help them establish a community around those solutions for use in the future.
Well, if you're interested, visit callforcode.org. My guest has been Daniel Krook, the Chief Technology Officer for IBM Code and Response and Call for Code. A lot of good things have come out of this, and you can be part of it. Daniel, thank you so very much for joining me.
Thanks for having me.